please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Rajnikant Patel, the former MD and CEO of BSC, and Deena Mehta, the MD of Asit C Mehta Investments, joins us now to analyze these guidelines and detail the impact. Thank you to both of you for joining us on CNBC TV18. Deena, I want to start with you. The new rules have gotten stricter and they also consider, you know, various things like a stock's valuation, price turns ratio, the client concentration, the movement in the stock price as well. Do you think all of this is good enough to improve the risk management system?
Actually, you see, the intentions of SEBI are laudable, that if there is some surveillance alert, it should be brought to the notice of the investors and inform them that, you know, something unusual is happening in a particular stock. But the method in which, you know, this whole implementation is happening, I think for a small investor, it is extremely complicated because we know that a lot of retail investors are participating in small and medium-term stocks. So according to me, you know, two things need to be done. One is you need to put a flag against the share, telling the person who is, you know, putting the order, immediately he will alert the investor that, you know, this stock is part of the ASM. And prior to that, I think a easier way to stem if any unusual activity is happening is, one is you caution the broker. Tell the broker that in your office something unusual is happening and you should, you know, take note of it, put a mechanism to, you know, prevent this risky trading which is happening by a couple of clients. So I think if that is done as a first step of cautioning the broker, I am 100% sure that no broker would, you know, would want to permit such activities in their office. And if that doesn't work, then you give an advance notice that, you know, this share is, you know, is going to go, because this surprise element is really, you know, short-charging the investor. Suddenly you come and, you know, you are told that this script has gone in ASM and the price start rolling down. So I think we need to serve our objective in a little bit different way than what is being done now. You know, and why should SEBI get into PE ratios and all these things? I mean, see, SEBI is, you know, anything to do with price, it is a market force which decides whatever has to do with price. You know, SEBI, you know, if it gets into price, it is a very, very, you know, very, very difficult area, because there'll be stocks who are much higher PEs, leading stocks will have high PEs, and why 100, why not 10, why not 2 times? I mean, these all numbers, everything, we get into a kind of a controversial area by, you know, putting in these numbers.
No, Deena, they are not talking about high PEs, they are looking at negative PEs, and, okay, yeah, greater than 30, but they are also matching it along with price variation. Now, if you know, if both those criteria are matched, it makes sense. I mean, after all, we have seen that over the past 18 months, people have lost serious money in some of these mid-cap and small-cap stocks, where we have seen crazy price variation. So as a protector of small investor interest, would it not be right on the part of SEBI to look at both? They're not looking at PE alone. They are only worried about the volatility.
No, see, point is what is the objective? Objective is to protect the small investor.
Yes.
And it is present investor versus future investor. The present investor, moment the item comes in this, there is a, you know, fall of 20, 30, 40% in the share. So suddenly the investor realizes that there is a fall. Okay, and since there is no flag which is available on the screen, what do brokers do? You know, we simply put a clampdown on all the scripts saying that, you know, no trading will be allowed in this unless, you know, you prove to us that you are a genuine buyer or a seller, then only we will allow you to trade. So, you know, this translating this good intention into a practical, you know, easily operatable, you know, how the markets are. Suddenly a person calls, you look, cut, people will just put in the order, buy, sell, and the thing goes forward. So, you know, this kind of scenario, it is very difficult to operationalize this. I think a easier way would be be to share the surveillance with the broker, tell him that something fishy is going on in your office. And I think that should be the first level of, correction. And if it doesn't happen, then other things can be triggered.
Okay.
So I feel that intention is laudable. The PEs are very high. I agree there is a bull run. And, whenever there is a market like this, when there is a high tide, you have all the garbage also coming on the shores.
Mm-hmm.
So in such situations, we are seeing that, some garbage does come on the shores. But then, we need to resolve this in a very practical and operationally easy manner, and the investor also doesn't lose out. Ultimately, you are doing it for the investor, but all the investors who are holding the stocks,
No, Deena, my point is, a page industries will not come in this PE, although it will be, trading at 50 or 60. That is not going to figure here because the variation will not be. Here it is clearly the garbage, which despite not having a PE is showing price variation. But we'll come to that in a bit. I take your point that maybe broker-wise alert is a new suggestion that you are bringing to the table. And let me toss that to someone who has been a kind of a semi-regulator, Rajnikant Patel, the former MD and CEO of BSE, is also with us. Mr. Patel, good morning. First, your reaction to what Deena Mehta is saying, that maybe a broker-wise alert that a couple of your clients are indulging in what looks like ASM-related stocks is a better way to go forward?
See, market oversight actually comprises of two things. One is the preventive and the other is corrective. So when you talk of preventive, you cannot take the measures which are actually available for a corrective action as a preventive measure. So information analysis and information intimation to the market player that there's something happening in the particular stocks which are of a small or a medium category where the price variations and ratios would be too high. I think what SEBI is doing, disseminating and transparently the criteria are also out in open. There are no more some confidential criteria. So the market awareness in terms of knowledge is there. Yes, the suggestion that broker-wise intimation might be sent, I think while measure may not have been specifically in implementation, but whenever exchanges through their own surveillance mechanism observe something, they do shoot out letters to the brokers in terms of asking clarification. So I think that mechanism is in place, though may not be very structured as we are looking at ASM, because which has now become a very structured way of market surveillance.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, in terms of the criteria, if you look at the criteria, I would say the criteria are generally in sync with trying to work the market oversight to a better level in terms of market price manipulation, the triggering of price manipulation, and also look at the client or a market operative concentration position. So I would say it's a good beginning, and the suggestions are as we implement, definitely we'll keep on getting more and more suggestions, and we might keep on implementing them.
Okay, so the intention is good, but it is counterproductive for small investors, as Deena was mentioning. Deena, the fear also is that because of these new and a lot more criteria, it could result in ASM being imposed in a lot more stocks. So the list could get much longer. Is that your fear as well?
Yeah. I mean, definitely, there would be, situations where these kind of movements do happen. And I mean, we have seen lot of times in the past, in case of new issue listings, in case of SMEs, in different kinds of shares, we do see because of the small stock which is available in the market, they are open to manipulation, and manipulation is very easy. And there have been instances where the prices are ramped up and then the people exit. So these things are very much there in the market. It is not as if we have made the markets foolproof, but fortunately now it is there in maybe 5% stocks or 5 or 7% stocks, unlike where speculation and price manipulation was very rampant. That those are days of the past. So there is a you know, I would say the elephant is out, but the tail still remains, where we do see manipulations. But you know, this you know, we have good intentions, but the today what I am seeing is that the retail investors are losing out heavily, because you come in the morning, suddenly you know this creep has gone in ASM, there is no notice, nothing at all, and you know, then the investor find is very difficult because the price has gone down. So you know, the current investor is losing out. We are cautioning the future investor that, you know, this something is fishy in the share, but current investor is paying a very heavy price. So I feel that you know, if we do the cost benefit analysis of this regulation, you know, something needs to be evolved in where, you know, we can stem these things before you know, you take a very transparent and open out the list to everybody. We should act on the alerts and catch the broker and his customers, whoever is doing this.
But why can't you all do it yourselves? I mean, this analytics, after all, the numbers are known. Won't you have the data? After all, you have price price data.
Now, we 100%.
You can do the preventive yourself.
Yes. No, we have got price data. All of us are having surveillance mechanisms in our office. Moment we see unusual behavior, we do, you know, write to the investor. We record his statement as to why did he buy this share, what were the reasons. So it is not as if we are not doing. But, you know, there would not be 100% of the people who are doing it. There would be some, you know, who are having large operations. They may not be doing it. So, I mean, you know, we cannot expect every broker to have the same level of surveillance. People who are conscious about the risk that they add to the system, we are all conscious. But there would still be, you know, instances which does not come to the light. And I think you should, you know, assist the broker in cautioning him that this is what is happening in your office.
Yeah. Okay. Mr. Rajnikant, the final word from you. Anything that can be done to tweak the system so that it doesn't hurt? Anything the exchanges can do?
Exchanges, in fact, I would say they are the first line of regulator, and they are actually doing this. And if you really, while it doesn't come out as a circular or a guideline, it's a part of an ongoing monitoring, and it happens almost every day constantly. And exchange surveillance mechanism actually throws out in near real time all these alerts, and they get, and that is where the integrated surveillance system of SEBI and exchanges actually comes as a second level, and then policy decisions get taken. Yeah, I would say it's a classical battle between the existing investor and the future investor, but we have to be a little bit more broad-based in terms of looking at the market as a whole and not only from one particular market actor's point of view.
Okay. Well, to both of you, thank you for taking the time out and explaining your viewpoints to us, but we need to take a short break on that note.